Hello. Welcome back to you asked for it and we're delivering. So welcome back to the corner. Cuz it's cooler that way. It's like the guy you don't call it facebook.com. You just call it the Facebook. You know what is cool? $1 billion. Justin Timberlake. We're going to be called The Corner. Some of us are very excited to bring it back. The producers and I have had a long conversation, and they said, if you want to keep doing the stupid things in between, you got to get the hits up. So I said, we'll do it. And it feels like I'm like Edward Murrow, who interviewed Liberace. And the only way he got to interview Liberace was by doing all the stuff about communism. There's a great movie about it that George Clooney's in that's called The Men Who Stare at Goats. You should check it out. I think it's on Netflix. So, and also today we have, this is a big one, a phone interview with Ryan Seacrest. You know, it's the Christmas season is coming up, and this is celebrity couple Christmas lists. And I have a couple different celebrity couples here. Kanye West and Kim Kardashian, they're a couple, and they have a baby named Northwest. And so Kanye is getting Kim a copy of North by Northwest on Blu-ray. Well, Nick Cannon heeded Mariah Carey's advice, and all she's getting this year is him. She has a song called, all I wanted for Christmas is you. Here's a celebrity who's been in the hot seat recently for some homophobic slurs, and that's Alex Baldwin. Mr. Baldwin recently attacked a couple of photogs. He's going to get his wife a camera so that she can take the pictures of him. So another segment, so we thought we would have a fun game with you, our audience. And this is a new game called They Tweeted What? The way that this game works is that we will give you the tweet and a little clue about the celebrity. And we will say, who do you think tweeted that? Which chemistry teacher turned meth cook tweeted this tasty concoction? I'm saddened by James Gandolfini's passing. He was a great talent and I owe him. I don't understand why we would pick that one. If you said Bryan Cranston, you got it. Which crooning hunk sang about Sopranos frontman's swan song with this tweet? Thank you, James Gandolfini, for some of the most brilliant TV moments of all time. So sad. Why is this a theme? He died like 6 months ago. Are you telling me that you only pick tweets about James Gandolfini dying? This is two. There's only three in here. Okay. If you said celebrity Josh Groban, you were correct. Okay. Last tweet, and I've been promised it's not about James Gandolfini passing. Rest in peace, by the way. Which new girl had this to tweet? This is such sad news about at Corey Monteith. What an absolutely tragic loss of a talented young man. You've got to be fucking kidding me. No, I know they do this on other shows. We looked at the other shows. None of them did anything like this. They didn't do tweets about a celebrity dying. They did tweets that were like pictures of like Lindsay Lohan with her dog, and it says like, taking muffin for a walk. You don't do this. I know celebrities die all the time. People die all the time. That's life. This is supposed to be a cute, stupid little segment about 140 fucking characters. It's a, okay. We're going to, this is our interview section, and we are gonna be talking to Ryan Seacrest, who you know as the host of This American Idol. He gave us his personal number in Belize, which is where he's vacationing with his family. All I have to do is enter the country code. And then hit the pound sign. And then enter the 15-digit phone.
We're sorry, the number you have dialed is not in service at this time.
The 4 that he jotted down looks like a 9. Pound. 27-digit. I'm getting the wrap it up signal. So we will, we're gonna go ahead and wrap it up. I'm sorry we couldn't get him on the phone. Next time we should call the person and have them on the phone so I can just pick it up. Yeah, better yet, have him in person. I just feel lost. I feel really lost in this chair.